All right. Well, thanks, Frank. Thanks, Zach. Joining us live on the show, Lima Central Catholic head coach Scott Palti. Coach, thanks so much for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me on.
You got to love seeing your guys there on the top five.
Yeah, that was right in front of me last week. That was a heck of a move. That was impressive. But yeah. Nothing he does seems to amaze me. He's an excellent football player.
You guys are having a great season. We'll talk about it here in a second. You know, you guys haven't had a lot of Friday games. You've had three Friday games. Most of your games have been Saturday, or you had the Thursday opener against Lima Senior. How do you kind of establish any type of rhythm for the week to get your guys ready, or are they just kind of used to back and forth going between Friday and Saturday?
Yeah, I think our kids have been used to it. We've played on Saturdays quite a lot the last few years, and you know, we try to keep as normal routine as possible. We play on a Saturday game. We do what we do usually on a Monday. We do it on a Tuesday, Wednesday, and so forth. And, you know, we really build it up. We tell our kids, hey, we're the only high school game around on a Saturday night. It's your chance to show off for the community and the area. Let's put a show on for people who want to come out and watch us. So our kids buy into that and have a lot of fun with it.
You know, following week one, you guys have rolled off. You know, your last five games have all been wins. Some of them have been pretty convincing. What have you seen in terms of growth from your football team from that week one loss up to week seven, which is where we're at right now?
Yeah, our kids obviously were really disappointed with the results of week one. Felt like, you know, we had chances to win that game and let some double-digit leads slip away. But our kids have done a great job of bouncing back from that loss. They've rallied troops and worked each week to get better. And I think now we're a much better football team going into week seven than we're going into week one. And, you know, I think that's the goal of any football team, to get better each week, and our kids have done that.
Absolutely. And something that helped you guys, if you've gotten a couple of players back, you've got Jay Riepenhoff back on offense. He's been playing defense for you the whole season, but now you got him back on offense, and he really provided a nice boost for you guys in your win last week.
Yeah, he's an excellent athlete. He had a great game last week. He had a couple touchdowns, and you know, he brings an element of another athlete to our offense, which really helps, you know, another weapon that we can use. And you know, add him to Sean and Rossi and Dylan, and you know, we got some guys we think can make a lot of plays for us. And he also blocks really well. So, yeah, just, you know, nothing but good things to say about Michael Jay.
You know, he complements that offense that's really so explosive now. I mean, you've got, you know, Nevin has looked really good. You've had Rossi looking really good. Sean Thomas, obviously, performing really well. These guys are putting up some really just insane numbers. How has it been with kind of making sure that there are enough touches for everyone to go around? Or do you even have that problem? Are there issues with making sure that all the guys have enough touches, so to speak, to make sure that they are contributing to the offense?
We are very fortunate. We've got a bunch of young men who are unselfish, and the only stat they care about is winning, which, you know, with that kind of those ability that those guys have, for them to only care about winning and not care about their stats, you know, what a luxury for myself and our coaching staff that those guys are, you know, that's their only concern. And you're right, they've had a great year. I think Sean's got 830 yards rushing and like 13 yards a carry, and Rossi's at like 650 with 10 yards a carry, you know, but you know, all they care about is winning, and you know, just a real joy to coach.
You guys have won a lot so far this season. You are not in a conference, so we're talking a lot. Well, we'll be talking about kind of conference standings and how things kind of shape up in the final few weeks of the season. You guys don't have a conference. How do you approach, how do you keep your kids motivated with kind of that extra gear besides just winning games? Because you've got other teams that you're playing that they're kind of fighting for conferences. You guys don't have that, so how do you keep your edge?
Yeah, obviously, not being in a conference, our ultimate goal is to qualify week 11 and play in the playoffs. You know, and to do that, you know, we have to emphasize getting better each week. If we are fortunate enough to make week 11, we're playing our best football. And, you know, our kids do a great job of treating each week, you know, kind of like a conference championship game, going out and playing hard and realizing that we need every victory we can get to qualify for week 11. And, you know, we get excited about that, and you know, that's what we have. We're not in the league, so that's what we shoot for each week, is to make sure we're working towards that ultimate goal to play our best football at the end of the year.
Tomorrow night, you guys match up with Kip Columbus. Kip Columbus, kind of a new team as far as OCHSAA. They played as a club sport last season. Now they've moved on to football. What are you looking for from Kip Columbus? What kind of matchup do you envision?
Yeah, like you said, they are new to the OHSA. They're a Division 7 team. Their record is 1-5 right now. They do play a very competitive schedule, but obviously they've had their struggles. And, you know, we try to worry about ourselves each week. Let's try to get better and play to our standards and what we expect of ourselves. And, you know, that's what we're shooting for, you know, to make sure we play as well as we possibly can and up to our capabilities. And, you know, hopefully tomorrow night when we walk off the field, we've done that.
Lima Central Catholic head coach Scott Palti. Coach, thanks for joining us, and good luck tomorrow.
Hey, thanks a lot for having me on.